अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लुक एट द मसल्स ऑफ द लेग. सो एज यू कैन सी दिस इज़ द नी हियर एंड द लेग स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम हियर ऑनवर्ड्स एंड देन दिस इज़ द फुट. सो द मसल्स ऑफ द लेग आर बेसिकली डिवाइडेड इनटू एन इंटीरियर कंपार्टमेंट एंड अ पोस्टीरियर कंपार्टमेंट. सो लुकिंग एट द मसल्स ऑफ द इंटीरियर कंपार्टमेंट, द मसल्स ऑफ द इंटीरियर कंपार्टमेंट इंक्लूड्स द टिबियालिस एंटीरियर. हियर यू कैन अप्रिशिएट दिस इज़ द टिबिया, tibia bone, and just anterior to it is the tibialis anterior. So this is tibialis anterior here. Then we have another muscle which is known as the extensor digitorum longus, this muscle here, and another muscle, a small muscle you can appreciate between the two, this is the extensor hallucis longus. So extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus, tibialis anterior, and we have another muscle which is known as the peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. So these are the muscles of the anterior compartment. Looking over the functions, so the function of tibialis anterior is the dorsiflexion of foot and inversion of foot. So tibialis anterior is basically responsible for dorsiflexion of foot. Dorsiflexion means the toes pointing upwards towards the sky. So tibialis anterior is responsible for dorsiflexion of foot as well as inversion of foot, and it also forms the medial longitudinal arch of the foot. Then we have extensor digitorum longus just next to the tibialis anterior here. Extensor digitorum longus, as its name indicates, it extends the digits. So it extends all the four toes here. And the extensor hallucis longus, which was between the two, a smaller muscle comparatively, it is for the extension of the big toe or the thumb. Hallucis refers to big toe or thumb. So extensor hallucis longus, it extends the big toe or the thumb. Then we have two muscles here, peroneus longus and peroneus brevis. Peroneus longus and peroneus brevis are responsible again for the dorsiflexion of foot as well as eversion of foot. So they are the everters of foot, while tibialis anterior was the inverter of foot. So these were the muscles of the anterior compartment. Moving over to the muscles of the posterior compartment, we divide the muscles of the posterior compartment into superficial muscles and deep muscles. So the main bulk of the posterior leg is formed by three muscles: gastrocnemius, soleus and plantaris. So here you can see the main muscle here, this is the gastrocnemius muscle here. It is included in the superficial group. So this is gastrocnemius muscle here. On the lateral head of gastrocnemius, here somewhere you can see another muscle which is the plantaris muscle here. If we remove the gastrocnemius, you can appreciate soleus muscle here. So gastrocnemius and soleus forms the main bulk of the posterior compartment of the leg. If we remove the gastrocnemius and soleus muscle, you can appreciate other muscles here, which are the muscles of the posterior compartment, the deep muscles of posterior compartment. Okay, so here you can appreciate tibialis posterior, this is tibialis posterior. Then you can see this is flexor digitorum longus, this is flexor hallucis longus. Here you can see popliteus muscle here. So we have four muscles again over here: popliteus, tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus and flexor hallucis longus. So if we discuss the functions of these muscles, the gastrocnemius and soleus, they are the main muscles of the posterior compartment superficial group, and they basically are the flexors of foot. They are the plantar flexors of foot. Plantar flexion, that is the toes pointing downwards towards the ground. So they are basically responsible for plantar flexion of the foot at the ankle joint, and gastrocnemius also flexes the knee, while the soleus is a postural muscle to steady the leg on the foot. Okay, now coming over the deeper muscles, as we have seen, this is the tibialis posterior. Tibialis posterior is also responsible again for the plantar flexion of the foot at the ankle joint, and it also inverts the foot. So tibialis posterior, plantar flexion and inversion of foit. Then we have popliteus muscle here. Popliteus is responsible for lateral rotation of femur on tibia prior to flexion. So it is responsible for lateral rotation. Then we have flexor digitorum longus. This is the flexor digitorum longus. Flexor digitorum longus is, as its name indicates, it flexes the digits. So it flexes the digits, while the flexor hallucis longus flexes the big toe or the thumb. These were the four deeper muscles, and gastrocnemius, soleus and plantaris forms the superficial muscles of the posterior compartment. Okay, here over the foot we can see a few structures over here. You can see the tendons over here. These are the tendons of the extensor hallucis longus and extensor digitorum longus. Here you can also appreciate a muscle. This is known as the extensor digitorum brevis here. It is also responsible for extension of the toes. Okay, here you can see ankle. There is a cremastaric ligament of the ankle here. You can appreciate the medial malleolus here and a lateral malleolus over here. You can also appreciate tendons of the peroneus longus and peroneus brevis over here. So basically on the foot we have all the insertions of the tendons of the muscles which are coming from the leg, which are coming from the anterior and posterior compartment of the leg, and they are being inserted over the foot. Thank you.